European Journal of Epidemiology, Wikipedia Audio. The European Journal of Epidemiology is a peer-reviewed medical journal on the epidemiology of communicable and non-communicable diseases and their control. The editor-in-chief is Albert Hoffman, chair of the Department of Epidemiology, Harvard T.H. Chan School of Public Health, Boston, United States. Antiano Sanna was the founding editor of the journal. As a clinical microbiologist and professor in microbiology in Siena and the Università Cattolica in Roma, Sanna was well versed in not only the field of microbiology, but also hygiene and public health. His original vision of the journal, as the description suggests, was to create a forum with a purpose beyond original emphasis on communicable disease. Other past accomplishments of Sanna in scientific writing was direct the Algiene Moderna, a public health journal created in 1908. The first issue of the European Journal of Epidemiology appeared in March 1985. The first journal particularly emphasized the epidemiology of infectious diseases, complete with 328 pages of abstracts, academic papers, and study results. Aside from academic material submitted by other professors and scientists, the journal featured a section to place announcements for upcoming symposia. These symposia, such as the Second International Symposium, gathered academics throughout Europe to discuss their own ideas and experimental findings. Sanna additionally decided to put an announcements segment where new publications regarding epidemiology, policy, and research written by contributing academics were advertised for purchase for the reader. Sanna probably intended for the journal to become a conduit for intellectuals to exchange news and developments. Origins. Starting in 1986, Sanna expanded the journal even further to draw feedback from his readers. He created a letters to the editor section that included scientific studies either relevant to a previous entry or a specific highlighted topic. Sanna also introduced a comments section and instructions to authors to encourage writing for the journal. The section showed guidelines on how entries should format their abstracts, references, figures, etc. in meticulous detail. A third expansion to the journal was the promotion of miscellaneous relevant classes and workshops, as well as an error carriage section in 1989 to show any corrections a reader has submitted from the previous issue. A possible explanation for these decisions is that they were reflections of Sanna's own experiences and personality traits. In other words, the weighted emphasis on open feedback and submissions to the journal parallel his open nature with new academics. He historically organized other symposia of his own and was known to be very welcoming, especially to younger intellectuals to gain fresh ideas. These additions perhaps reflect his nature as a professor with organizational talents. Just as Sanna demonstrated during his 6 years as editor-in-chief, all editors succeeding him have made unique impressions on the European Journal of Epidemiology, adding to both the content and structure of the journal. Sanna's era, from 1985 to 1992, set out to create a forum for academics. However, after his death in 1992, Carlo Schezzi inherited the position of editor-in-chief for 2 years. Schezzi's era could be considered an extension of Sanna's, considering that he did not set out to make too many changes to the journal. His main objective was to continue the legacy of the journal and maintain its popularity among academics. He mostly stabilized the growth of the journal. As a pupil of Dr. Sanna himself, Schezzi carried out Sanna's vision. Major changes to the journal came when Claude Hanoun took over for 8 years from 1994 to 2002. During his time as editor-in-chief, Hanoun set out to change the direction of the journal. He sought articles that applied more to population health and non-communicable diseases. Moreover, he increased the number of publications from 10 to 12 issues a year, one for each month, and extended the distribution of the journal. As Hanoun stepped down from the editor-in-chief position to editor emeritus, Albert Hoffman agreed to take over in 2002. He is now the Stephen B. Kay Family Professor of Public Health and Clinical Epidemiology and Chair of the Department of Epidemiology at the Harvard T.H. Chan School of Public Health. Under Professor Hoffman's editorship, the EJE has seen its standing in the community and its impact factor develop significantly. The current aims and scope covers the different fields of epidemiology, a science which has always been multidisciplinary by nature. Contributions are encouraged from the fields of public health planning and control, economy, preventive medicine, clinical trials, vaccinology, psychology, molecular biology, mathematical modelization, and computer sciences. Within and outside its geographical borders, Europe is involved in a number of new problems, including those concerning public health. Epidemiologists on this continent will have to take into account more and more often economical, psychological, social, and even political dimensions at national, regional, and global levels. It has often been a concern for European scientists to find a medium for publication without the risk of rejection by international referees on the basis of local interest. Although peer review for publication in European Journal of Epidemiology is rigorous and very strict, the European interest of the data presented is also taken into consideration. Articles are carefully refereed and selected to provide the reader with the most up-to-date, original, well-designed, well-interpreted and significant information in the field of epidemiology. Original articles, reviews, short communications, commentaries and letters to the editor are considered for publication. Proceedings of relevant symposia and monothematic issues on topics of particular interest are occasionally published as supplements. First issue. With a 2016 impact factor of 7.226, the EJE is ranked 6th out of 176 in the category, Public, Environmental, and Occupational Health. The EJE's SJR in 2016 was 4.008. The SJR is a size-independent prestige indicator that ranks journals by their average prestige per article. It is based on the idea that all citations are not created equal. SJR is a measure of scientific influence of journals that accounts for both the number of citations received by a journal and the importance or prestige of the journals where such citations come from. It measures the scientific influence of the average article in a journal. It expresses how central to the global scientific discussion an average article of the journal is. http://www.scimagojr.com/index.php. Editors-in-Chief. Content. Impact.